Remember, my respected brothers and sisters in Islam, when Allah sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he left the cave, going home, he was the only Muslim in this world. Everyone was a kafir. From his wife to the last person to live in Makkah, they were all kuffar. Remember that. And when he came, his wife accepted Islam. His friend accepted Islam. His cousin accepted Islam. Bilal accepted Islam. And they kept accepting, accepting, accepting until Islam is what we see today. So don't think that these people were born Muslims. They were not born Muslims. Most of them were that is the children of those who accepted Islam. So they were not actually originally born Muslims. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, when he looked at the Sahaba, he told them, I'm not better than any of you. They said, why? Why do you have to show arrogance? Is it because you are the leader of Muslims? He said, no. But I read in the Quran where Allah says that anyone who used to do bad and then stop the bad and start doing good, I change his bad into good. And from the look of things, I don't think there is any of you who was more bad than me when I used to be a Muslim. He buried his daughter alive. He said, I'm looking, I can see the time when I was burying my daughter. She was pushing the son up to me, father, father. But no, that was the sunnah of the day and I buried my daughter alive. Didn't he lead the Muslims? He did lead the Muslims. You don't look at what is the past of a human being or any person and say, no, this man was a DJ. He can be a DJ, and being a DJ yesterday can make him to be a khatib, a preacher, because he had an experience in kufar or in kufr, and he has turned it into Islam. Then Allah gave him for everything he used to say when he used to be a DJ. Allah make it what? Allah make it a reward instead of a sin. This used to be the lives of the Sahaba of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So coming back to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Allah is the one who make love and mercy between you and your wife. Why love and mercy? Allah is saying that in the Quran. It's not only your love to your wife. You love her for something. We all love the woman when she is beautiful. A brother made a joke some time ago and told me when he came, he wanted to get married. Long time ago, and he got married, actually, may Allah bless his marriage. He came and said, brother, I want to get married. What type of woman? Inshallah, hijab. She's praying, she's dying. This is the only thing I want. I don't want anything again apart from this, in accordance with the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I say, inshallah, pray that we get a woman or we get a sister for you. He said, okay. Salaamu alaikum. Before he left the door, then he looked at me and said, Sheikh, inshallah, some beauty. We all want something that is beautiful, just definitely. But what you have to understand is that the beauty you are seeing today is going to change tomorrow. Someone said, if you want to know how your wife is going to look tomorrow, before getting married to her, look at her mother. So that you can see what face you're going to see tomorrow. It is not the beauty of the face. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he married Khadija, she was older than him. But she was a beautiful woman. But when she died, still there was some love. What type of love was that? It's a love of rahmah, a love of mercy. Allah says, he made love and mercy together. You love her not only because of her beauty, the beauty of her face, she has characters. She has a way of taking care of your children. She's the mother of your children. She's the foundation of your life. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying that this world is a place of joy. And the best joy you can get is to have a good woman. They say, Messenger of Allah, describe a good woman. He said, whenever you look at her, you are happy. Pleased with her. And whenever you command her, she obeys you. And whenever you are absent, she takes care of your money. And she does not give herself out to anyone. These three conditions, if you have them in your wife, then know that you are a happy person. He said, لا يفرق مؤمن مؤمنة إن كره منها خلقا ورضي منها خلقا آخر. You should not hate your wife. If you dislike a character within your characters of your wife, look within her characters, there is something good about her. Love her for that sake. So the love has to continue until even after her death or your death. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he conquered Makkah without fighting, the first thing he did was that he didn't say, show me a place to build my house. He said, direct me to the grave of Khadija, radiallahu anha. Remembering her when she was alive, whenever he slaughters a lamb, he has to give part of the lamb to the friends of Khadija, brother Lam. He loved her when she was already gone. Then again, someone was coming to visit the house. The Prophet was with Khadija, sorry, with Aisha radiallahu anha. He said, Allah, make this be the sister of Khadija. And when she came, she was the sister of Khadija. Aisha couldn't have patience with that. Every time Khadija, this old toothless woman in her grave, you love her still? He said to Aisha radiallahu anha, she accepted me when everyone refused me. She helped me with her money and her position. Not over me, but still I was her husband. And she gave me children that none of you would give me.
Allah.
He didn't say she was beautiful. Did he say that? No. That is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the mother of my children. How do you want your own mother to be treated by your father? You think our fathers were so good to our mothers? Our mothers were very patient. So they don't make us see what our fathers are doing. Or the bad side of our fathers. The same, you don't have to make your house to be a place where you have Russia and America fighting day and night. No. Let a fight be between you and your wife alone. Fighting is permissible. You not fight, you not have a solution. It's not fighting like you use your hands. Have differences between you, then you have a solution. And so many times, if you only want to have happiness in your wife and in your family, let your wife always be the winner. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says about women, لا يكرمهن إلا كريم ولا يحيلهن إلا لعين يغلبن كل كريم ويغلبهن لعين وأنا أريد أن أكون كريما مغلوبا من أن أكون لعيما غالبا. He said, you not see someone to be kind to the woman unless someone who is generous, a generous husband. You be doing good to her. And you don't see someone who will be wicked to his wife unless the person who is naturally a wicked person. But whenever you see a marriage, the woman always, when he sees that you are very generous and soft and kind, she always try to rule over you. But the wicked man who is not kind to her is always ruling her. And I, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I choose between the two. I would like to be a generous loser than to be a wicked winner. If your woman commands you at home, it doesn't mean anything. It is not in the face of people. She herself knows very well that you are above her. You are her husband. You are everything. When she insults you and then you reply, she insults and then you reply, you are giving her strength. Because the woman has no strength unless where? The tongue. See the stories of prophets. Allah will say, then we solve his problem and clean the tongue of his wife.